And it does support what you were saying, that a lot of people do feel that they can look back at an earlier period. But let me just, let's go back 180 years for a second, and to the 1820s. In the 1820s, objectivity was really non-existent. All the newspapers in the 1820s were run by political parties. In fact, editors and publishers were paid by the Whigs and the Democrats, the two main political parties in the United States. So the idea of being detached from political parties or nonpartisan was completely non-existent before the 1830s. So that's one, if we look back that far, 180 years, we see that it just wasn't happening. And then in my book, I argue that objectivity evolved step by step until the 1890s, when all of these elements that I talk about in my book were finally in place.
What, talk to us about some of those now. What were some of the key moments in this evolution?
I look at the 1820s and the evolution, the birth of nonpartisanship and detachment in the 1820s and 30s and 40s. And then I look at the inverted pyramid, which I just mentioned, with Edwin Stanton, who was writing this form before others. Then I look at the rise of reverence for facts. I look at certain cholera epidemics in New York City in the 19th century. In the 1830s, there was a cholera epidemic, and people would look to all kinds of strange reasons for the disease, including cucumbers, the weather, you should wear your flannels, and it hasn't rained in a couple of days, so therefore there might be cholera. And journalists and doctors together didn't really understand how to cure it, how to prevent it. Doctors would rub mercury into the gums of patients, which is just awful to think about. By the 1860s, journalists and doctors together had a new love of facts and data gathering, and were able to combat the disease through this scientific method. So that evolved, and that helped journalists to evolve to revere facts and to appreciate what data gathering could bring to their craft. And then finally, in the 1890s, all of these elements were in place. And in addition, the concept of balance, balancing two sides to a story, finally, all of these were in place. But in fact, in the 1890s, despite that all of these elements were in place, journalists still oftentimes could not get the stories completely right.